Hi there, this is Lola, and thank you for joining me. God bless you. I really appreciate you coming back for more of God's Word. And today in God's presence, I received this instruction from the Lord, like a command. I heard the Lord says, let there be light. We all like to be in a place where there is light, to see what we are doing, where we are going, where we are putting our feet. But the Lord says this particular command points to two things. First of all, this command, as it's manifesting in your life right from this moment, it will do two things. First of all, this light from above will chase out every hidden things, every secret things that shouldn't dwell. And secondly, be a pointer, giving divine directions and clarity. And I'm praying every one of you in their need of God's light to bring to the fore, to the open, what is in the secret or every strange power hiding. I'm praying that the light of the Lord will be an eye-opener to things, to closures, to things you need to know and be aware of that had happened in the past or currently happening in your life in Jesus' mighty name. Now, let there be light as a command means three things according to what the Lord highlighted to me. And the Lord wants me to share these 3 points with you. The Lord says, let there be light could mean let stagnation come to an end. Where there is darkness, there is stagnation. And the Lord is saying this light from above. You know, the Lord Jesus Christ made this statement, said, I am the light of the world. And his light is shining upon everything that is stagnated in the mighty name of Jesus. You know, the Bible talked about a man who sat at the pool of Bethesda for good 38 years. This man was living a bleaky life, a stagnated life, waiting for that one day the angel will disturb the water and he will be the first person to jump into this water to receive his breakthrough. Maybe you've been waiting at your own pool, expecting something to happen, expecting a shift, expecting angelic intervention. The Lord says, let there be light in that stagnated situation in your life. And things are moving and shifting in your favor in Jesus' mighty name. The Lord is uprooting every stagnated power of darkness. And light is shining and you are moving from that position in Jesus' mighty name. Yes. Again, the Lord says, let there be light, point to let darkness go. You know, the book of John chapter 1 verse 5 says, the light shines in darkness, and darkness did not comprehend it. Where there is darkness, there is hardly any progress there. There is hardly any source of celebrations or joy or happiness. To every one of you that you've been living in darkness, you have nothing to celebrate about you. You've been waiting for a long time and you can't just wait for your breakthrough to come. Let darkness go now in the mighty name of Jesus. And let there be light. The light that darkness cannot comprehend that comes from above. In the name of Jesus. And again, let there be light means let sorrow come to an end. Again, the Bible talks about a woman who was going to bury a only son. And this woman had divine encounter with the Lord on the way. And the one who says, I am the life, who is also the light, transformed the whole situation and the dead came back alive. The light of the Lord is going into that dead situation. In the mighty name of Jesus, the Lord is turning sorrow to joy because where there is light, there is fulfillment, there is joy, there is peace in the Holy Ghost. I'm praying according to the word of the Lord, let there be light in your life. in your situation, let sorrow come to an end. Let pain come to an end. Let the light radiate and bring beauty to your situation, to your life in the mighty name of Jesus. Let light of God expose every darkness in the mighty name of Jesus. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. We receive your word. Let there be light all over our lives, our homes, our situations, to your glory in Jesus' mighty name. Newcomers are welcome. We love you here. And I'm praying God will bless every returning subscriber. Jesus loves you, and I do. Peace and love. Shalom.